July 3rd, 2014. You are listening to episode number 8 of the Super Magic Sex Show. My name's Lando. I'm here with my friend Obi and a very special guest. What time is it?
It's motherfucking game time.
Game time.
Game time. Also, 7:42.
Also 7:42. Okay, great. This is a special episode because we are in a different studio as a result of a current hurricane striking us.
Yeah, we're literally in the midst of a hurricane right now.
And we have a hurricane party on top of that.
On stolen time, waiting for the power to go out. But it's still here, so...
And on top of that, we also have a very special episode because we have our show's first guest. Woo! We are welcoming from the hills of South Carolina. Welcome, the Chief. The hills. I don't know. Are they there hills there?
Sure, yeah.
Sure, yeah. You're from the hills.
Oh, there's totally hills. There's hills everywhere in South Carolina.
Chief, how you doing, man?
Hey, I'm doing all right.
Welcome, Chief. So we understand that you traveled here. I mean, you are not from this state. You are from much further south than we are.
I'm just up here doing a football camp for the summer.
Okay.
Football's kind of my profession. It's my thing. It's
so
my passion.
Is this, football is your profession. Is this something that you work with professional teams?
Well, I work for a middle school.
Okay.
In South
so
Carolina.
So you're what, like a middle school coach?
Well, you know... I'm a volunteer.
You're a volunteer.
But I get those boys motivated. Yeah, and I get them out there and ready to kick some butt.
Kick some butt. So you're up here. For training camp for middle school?
13 to 14 year old boys.
I take it this is your program, like head coach kind of thing?
I'm very passionate about it. No, I'm the assistant coach of special teams.
Special teams.
Special teams.
Special teams for 13-year-olds?
Well, 13 and 14, 7th and 8th graders.
Okay.
And at Pokemon Middle School down in South Carolina.
Now,
Pokemon?
Yes,
Pokemon.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. That is correct.
I thought you had said Pokemon.
That's what I thought you said, too.
Pokemon. No, I don't know if I like that or not.
I'm sorry. Chief, I'm sorry.
You know, those... My granddaddy went over there and fought the Japs back in World War II.
I don't know if
I just don't know if I can trust them or not.
I don't know if Japs is the proper nomenclature, but I understand what you're getting at. So, Chief, welcome to the show. Welcome to our hurricane party. We're gonna be here for a while because we have to wait for this hurricane to pass. So we're gonna get into a lot of the work that you do. I want to really kind of delve into this. And, learn more about you and welcome you as our very first guest.
Let me just stop you one second, Lando, with that. There's really only two things you need to know about me.
Okay.
I love football.
Okay.
And I love Jesus. And that's about it.
Don't we all? Who does?
Yeah, what about soccer? What are your feelings on soccer? Do you like soccer?
I don't believe I'm familiar now, with that.
Okay.
Wait, is this what those little rich boys do and they run around and little...
Well, actually, soccer is mainly, it's essentially the least expensive sport ever invented.
You do know that the World Cup's going on right now, like the biggest tournament in the world.
Let me ask you all this. Why are we worried about the world when there are people starving right here in America?
That's a good point.
That is a good point.
What's going on? I mean, why do I care what's going on in Africa or South America or wherever? When there are people right here in the United States that can use that money.
They don't need to kick around a ball. What they need is a little bit of Jesus.
They could use a little bit of Jesus, but you know what else they could use? A little bit of elbow grease. And a little bit of work. Instead of kicking that ball around all day, we could put them to work. They can make a little extra money, and maybe they wouldn't be starving all the time.
Come play for your special teams or something.
I don't think that would happen. That takes some big boys to do that. They need a lot of beef and a lot of protein in that diet in order to do that stuff. I mean, I'm just gonna be straight up. I'm just gonna be straight up with y'all. I mean, that's just the way it is.
Now, I'm not gonna lie. I've before getting you on the show, I had to do something of not a background check, but I did call your employees just because actually I was trying to get your phone number and I knew you'd be in town. Wait a minute.
You don't work for the federal government now, do you?
I do not.
Are you sure?
I'm positive. And
I don't know if I'm down with that.
Legally, I'd have to tell you, otherwise it's entrapment. You know that. Right. You know about entrapment laws.
Well, I'm going
to
trust you this time, Linda.
Okay. So anyway, I checked into a little bit of your professional background just because I was trying to get your contact information. And so it's my understanding, you know, I mean, we just had a general chat, nothing nosy. But I said, you know, how does he work with the young men? They explained to me that, now correct me if I'm wrong, but you're a bit of a disciplinarian. Is that a fair assessment?
Well, I'm just going to tell you the way it is. All just right. Like my daddy taught me.
That's right.
You just got to keep them boys in line.
How do you?
And they got to learn some discipline at a young age.
Now, one thing, I mean, I played youth sports. I remember being 13. I actually played.
Now, did you now, Lando? Because you don't look like the athletic
I didn't.
Yeah, you just.
Hey, did he you was play a hockey player, right? Did you play hockey, right?
I wasn't the best.
Did you play a little tennis back
in the day?
Let's play some tennis.
I'm just being upfront with you now.
Regardless of the sport I played, maybe it was tennis, maybe some golf, whatever. It doesn't matter. Okay. My point is, when there was a conflict, a lot of what I learned, and I think this is a helpful skill in, you know, my professional life and as an adult that I've carried on through lessons I've learned through sports. When there's a problem, when you need to keep someone in line, I found a very good coaching technique was to kind of talk it out. How do you feel about that?
Talk. No, I'm gonna tell you what you do. When you got to motivate a player and he's got to go out there and hit somebody. I mean, this is battle. Football's battle.
It is battle.
And you got to get
out
there.
You just
got to
hit the piss out of it.
You got to destroy the other team.
That's right.
So you grab him by that face mask. You pull him right in there. You give him the wild eyes. And when you do that,
you say, wait, get out there.
I thought when you pull the face mask, that's a penalty.
Not as a coach?
No, as a coach.
A coach can commit penalties?
Yes.
So you're teaching your kids to commit penalties, but they can't. What the fuck?
Oh, my Lord. Oh, my goodness. No. When you're motivating them, before you're even going out there, you grab that kid by the face mask, you get right in the eyes, you can give him the wild
eyes. The listeners can't see this, but Chief is actually giving us an example of the wild eyes. And it's motivating me right now.
Had I been wearing a mask over my face, it would have been pulled.
Yep.
And yanked,
mm-hmm.
And I would have gotten the wild eye in the face.
Now, what I did know, actually recently, just driving by Pokemon School, I don't know if you were involved with this. I mean, it wasn't a game. It was clearly practice. And I did see you there. I saw you there with you know, your uniform on and the whistle, coaching the special teams, of course. And it's my understanding that one of the 13-year-olds suffered from a herniated disc in his upper spine, and that was during practice. And because I saw the ambulance there, and I later on read about this in just a local school report, there's rumors that you actually pulled the face guard a little too hard, giving him the crazy eyes, and there was a neck injury. Now, are you in any way responsible for that, or is it his fault?
Now, look, I'm just going to tell you the way it is.
Okay.
That boy.
Sorry, you just seem to have like a catchphrase. You just
should not have been out there to begin with.
Why not?
Summertime. Shorter, he was way shorter than the other kids. He was always wanted. Oh, coach, I hurt my leg. Oh, coach, I hurt my arm. He didn't want to work. He didn't want to do any work. He wasn't out there to help the team. All he wanted to do was wear some pads and look fancy running around.
Okay.
So you yanked his face.
And
now
he has a herniated disc in his upper spine. Now, did he deserve it?
You know, I never did like doctors that much. My daddy, when I hurt myself, my daddy would give me a whooping. And then after that whooping, you say, now, son, you take a salt tablet, you drink a little bit of water, and you get back out there. And you do your job. And you know what? I turned out just fine.
Now, when you coach, I've noticed you do wear a fanny pack. And because I've seen you on the field for the special teams. When the special teams come out, You seem to be feeding him something. Are those salt tablets? Like you're pulling something out of the fanny pack and you're giving it to him.
Salt tablet will cure any kind of football injury.
No,
you just give the kid a salt tablet, a little bit of water, maybe a little bit of Gatorade and all over on the side, and they're good to go. Yes, that is what's in my pink fanny pack.
No, just to be clear, it was pink because it was Breast Cancer Awareness Month.
No, sir, real men wear pink.
Okay.
Friend to hang out on the weekend.